She's known as the crafty chica. Horizonte's Nadine Arroyo Rodriguez reports how the crafty chica is showing others how to make art with a touch of Latino style.
Meet one of the Valley's most skilled craft artists, Kathy Cano Murillo, but she's better known as the Crafty Chica. For nearly 8 years, this Latina has been making all types of arts and crafts with a touch of Latino flair, while at the same time teaching her fans how to also be their own Crafty Chica.
I call it squeezing a dollar out of a dime. I heard that phrase in one of my favorite movies, and it's just about taking something small or something about yourself and then making it bigger and really, really embracing it and celebrating it. And, you know, that's the whole thing of Crafty Chica, whether if it's an art project or an idea that you have or just something about your personality that you're really proud of.
Kathy was the Crafty Ideas columnist for the Arizona Republic. Her column shared new projects and enhanced old ones. After a short local run, her column became a hit, and it soon went national, published in numerous cities around the country.
I just loved the thought that all these people were reading about my goofy little craft project ideas. And I've always been the kind of person to think of what is that next level. So I thought of people who didn't subscribe to the newspaper, who I wanted to reach them as well. So one day at work, I was on deadline for a story, and it just popped in my head, Crafty Chica.
In no time, she created a website and linked her readers to the Crafty Chica homepage. With the help of her husband, Patrick, an artist in his own right, Kathy began sharing her ideas. The Crafty Chica advertisement-free website gets 2 to 3 million hits a month, marketed by word of mouth and link trades, and the ideas are all free. This Crafty Chica made what some call a hobby into a working adventure.
We call it enthusiastic desperation, where we knew we had to have all these different avenues to bring in income to keep working. And that was back in the day, you know, in the early 90s when we first got married. And now here it is, you know, many, many years later, and all of those things have really escalated to bigger national level type of projects. The main bulk of what I do is the website because it's free. I've never had any ads on there. I run it all by myself, and it's all I do is post projects for people to make. I post, you know, what it's like to be in my shoes. Of some days it's good, some days it's bad. I just share it on there, and then people comment, and that's like a really fun part of all of it that I love, is just the networking aspect of it.
The profits she makes are in her 48 various trademarked products sold at craft stores throughout the country. They include Crafty Chica fabric paint, glitters, stencils, books, and workshop craft kits.
All the different things that Patrick and I have used over the years in our artwork that we sold, even our trade secrets, we package them all up into these really cool little workshop in a box, and then we have our paints, and on every box I put a little tip on how to use it, because I know when we started as artists, we didn't have a lot of money to spend on supplies. So these products are like what we started with, and I put on there all the different ways that you can use them so that people will really, you know, be able to stretch them out.
And that's not all. Kathy will release her first novel in 2009.
I love it. I mean, to me, writing is like making art, except instead of choosing paint colors, you're choosing words. And I love that. It can take you to a whole different place. My idea is that I just want to keep posting more and more projects, because eventually one will hit. You know, I figure the more I post on there, the more chances of someone seeing something and saying, okay, that I can make. You know, I'm going to try that. And it's such a great feeling for them to write me back and send me a picture of what they made. I'm like, yes, they're converted.
Kathy Cano Murillo and her husband have an upcoming exhibition, La Casa Murillo, a life-size shadow box, that will be on display at the Heard Museum starting in October.